If you've ever tried to run custom scripting or batch files in a network share folder that isn't mapped to a letter drive in Windows, you may have encountered an issue where the command prompt just closes immediately and your command never goes through. I struggled with this for a while and never really immediately found out a reason why it happened, but for my workflow, using network or using drive letter mappings wasn't an option. Well, I finally found the solution, and I'm going to share it with you. Right after this. TubeBuddy is the best tool you can get to manage your YouTube channel. You can update videos in bulk, optimize your SEO, syndicate to social media, back up your metadata, and more, all with a simple browser extension. Head to eposvox.com/TubeBuddy to learn more and download it for free. This is a little bit of a niche recommendation or problem to solve, but I've been working on my efficiency and I wanted to make a batch file that I can then assign to a button on my Stream Deck or a right-click context menu item that makes a bunch of folders for me. And that's not going to let me do it. So I'm going to show you the code here real quick. Super basic script. Literally mkdir or directory or md and then a bunch of folders. In theory, should work. But when I try to run it in my video project folders, nothing happens. And that's really bizarre. I've seen video evidence of this command working. This is how it works. I'm not a programmer, but I at least have the basic understandings, and I solve videos with it as well. However, if I make a folder on my desktop and put the batch file in there, and then run it, it works fine. There's a little bit of a refresh delay, but it works. So why the heck won't it work in my project files? Well, it's because the way that I have all of my network drives mapped is by host name. It is a network map, like file location mapping, not a mapped drive letter. Now, I do have network mapped drive letters because I wish to monitor how much space is available, and certain applications require drive letters, but I avoid using them when at all possible for my project files. Because if I import footage and make the project files with a drive letter, then when I open them up on another computer, the drive letters won't be there, or they'll be mapped differently, or any kind of situation, and the entire project will need relinking, and it's just a nightmare. Whereas if I have everything on a centralized network storage, it works fine. I have spent half an hour digging through Stack Overflow and forum posts trying to figure out why. A lot of them recommend disabling some security things in the registry and a lot of stuff that honestly shouldn't be done. And then finally, like half an hour later, I finally found this one little command to add to the start of the batch file, which temporarily maps the directory you're in to a root, to like an actual drive, and then the batch will run. Because otherwise, as you see, it just closes automatically and it gives some error about not having a UNC path. This is by design. Windows does this on purpose so that if you have UAC or user access control enabled, you can't, you know, infect other computers if you're a virus, basically, which is pretty smart. So what you have to do is edit your batch file here, which I have already opened, but I'm using Notepad++, and just add this command, push D, space, parentheses, squiggly, DP0. And yes, I call it squiggly, I know, get over it. So just paste that in there at the start of your script, hit save, and then when you rerun it, like magic, and a couple seconds of delay of Windows Explorer's really slow refresh, we have files. So this is the first step of a future project, but I just figured this out, wanted to share it with you. And that's it. I hope you enjoyed. Hit the like button if you did. Get subscribed for more awesome tech content and usually more accessible stuff. I realize this is super niche, but if you've ever had issues getting batch files to run on network shares, this might be your fix. Check us out on Patreon at patreon.com/eposvox to contribute to free tech education such as this. And I'll see you in the next video.